फ्रॉम एलपी सवाणी रिवर साइड स्कूल कृपाली हूँ।
हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, अवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज रीजनरेशन। एज द नेम सजेस्ट यू, जनरेशन मीन्स टू प्रोड्यूस, री मीन्स अगेन। अगेन इफ समथिंग इज प्रोड्यूस देन इट इज कॉल्ड रीजनरेशन एंड दिस प्रोसेस इज ऑल्सो मेनली रिलेटेड टू दिस टर्म। लेट्स स्टार्ट। Many fully differentiated organisms have the ability to give rise to new individual organisms from their body parts. That is, if the individual is somehow cut or broken up into many pieces, many of these pieces grow into separate individuals. For examples, here is talking about if one new healthy organism will, if lost some body parts, then that body parts will itself grow as the separate individuals. For example, simple animals like Hydra and Planaria can be cut into any number of pieces and each piece will grow into a complete organisms. This is known as the regeneration. What is the meaning is, suppose we are going for example of human beings. It is not actually possible in the human beings, but if we are suppose going to think in the human beings, if we have 10 fingers but by some accident if I'm losing one finger, then what will happen? Then one finger will have ability to generate whole body from that finger cells. That's why it is known as regeneration, but unfortunately it's not possible in human beings. But we can take example of the Hydra and Planaria. What is happen then, if Hydra is removing one part of the body, then that one body part will able to regenerate the whole body from that particular parts. This is known as the regeneration. Regeneration is carried out by specialized cell. All body cells don't have the ability of perform the process, but specialized cell only can go for the regeneration. The cells proliferate and make large numbers of cell, means they will grow to make the large cell numbers. From this mass of cell, different cell undergo changes to become various cell type and tissues. And if the cell which is specialized is go for the proliferation for the overgrowth, then that cell mass will be form the separate kind of the cell mass. Suppose here you can see that this is the whole body of the Hydra, which have particular kind of the body structure as you can see here. But because of the certain circumstances, what is happens, there is happens two kind of the cuts and its body will be get divided into three parts. Now just because this uppermost part have some kind of information, that's why it will go for this kind of reproduction. What will happen with the first portion? It will form the rest of the body structure and at the maturation state it will look exactly like its parent cell. With the middle part, what will happen? It will regenerate the uppermost and lowermost part and it will look exactly like its parent cell, and with the lower part it will form the upper body part. It means this fragmented body will be generate the rest of the body parts and they will live as a new individuals, and this method of the reproduction is known as the regeneration. Again, this body part will generate their body, that's why it is known as the regeneration. It takes place in organized sequence referred to as development. However, regeneration is not the same as reproduction, since most organisms would not normally depend on being cut up to able to reproduce. It means all organisms not are following this method of the reproduction, because all cell have not information that how to grow rest of the body. If we are taking example of this one, suppose this mass of the cell don't have information how to regrow this rest of the body, then it will be not grow into this kind of the state. It means if you are going to regenerate, if you are going to reproduce yourself with the help of regeneration, then your cell have your cell must have the information of the data how to regenerate rest of the body. It means regeneration will be performed by the specialized kind of the cells only. Next one is the budding. Organisms such as Hydra use regenerative cells for reproduction in the process of budding. In the budding process, you can take example of the Hydra. It is regenerate. In Hydra, a bud develops as an outgrowth due to the repeated cell division at one specific site. It means if you are going to see here, see this one is the healthy Hydra, but because of the overgrowth of cell, here will be bud will form. Here at a particular site, overgrowth of the cell will occur, and that's why bud-like structure, node-like structure will be formed. And by the overgrowth of this bud, the new Hydra will be formed. And after this new Hydra will be formed, there will be cut. Here you found that cut will happen, and that's why at a result there will be two Hydra will form from the one. This parent will be remain as it is, but they will give a bud to a new offspring. This bud develops into tiny individuals. It means this bud will be grow into new individuals. When fully mature, when this Hydra, baby Hydra will be get fully mature, then it will be detached. It means be separated from the parent plant. Detached from the parent body and become a new independent individual. When it will get detached, then it's not dependent on their parents for its own growth. Next one is the vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation means there are many plants in which parts like roots, stem, leaves develop into new plants under appropriate condition. It's not necessary that each and every plants have the seeds for its reproduction. Some are also like that, they don't have seeds and they are grown from their roots, stems and leaves. This method of the reproduction is known as the vegetative propagation. Unlike in most animals, plants can indeed use such a mode of reproduction. This property of vegetative propagation is used in methods such as rearing or grafting to grow many plants like. Which plants are going to undergo the vegetative propagation? Here is example: sugarcane, roses or grapes. For agricultural purpose, because sugarcane, roses and grapes, none of these having a seed. Plants raised by vegetative propagation can bear flowers and fruits earlier than those produced from seeds. It means these kind of plants having the flower also and fruit. Such method also make possible the propagation of plants such as banana. In the banana also vegetative propagation is possible. Banana, orange, rose and jasmine that have lost their capacity to produce seed. If the banana, orange, rose and jasmine plant have lost the ability of producing seed, then it can also go for the vegetative propagation. Even if orange have seed, it can also be generated by the vegetative propagation with the help of the stem, root and the leaves. Another advantages of vegetative propagation is that all plant produce are the genetically similar enough to the parent plant to have its all characteristics. It means even if I am growing one plant of the banana from the parent's plants by the root sample, it doesn't mean that the new offspring will not have some quality exactly like the parent plant. It means even if I'm growing something with the help of vegetative propagation by the sample of root, stem of leaves of particular kind, then also it will be have the same quality exactly like the parent plant. They will have same leaf structure, same root pattern and same the stem structure also with the same kind of the food. It means vegetative propagation will be also helpful in the agriculture. Activity number 8.5 we will see in the next session.